What up guys, Adrian from YouMotorcycle.com here with a new video. We're going to be talking about motorcycle ABS and why it may become mandatory whether you want it on your bike or not. Today's video is going to be a bit of a different format than past ones, so if you like it, please hit that like button and hit subscribe, and if you don't like it, leave a comment letting me know what you didn't like. Today we're going to be answering four questions. Who's pushing to make ABS mandatory? What the reasoning behind it is? Why some riders are for mandatory ABS while other riders are against it? And what does this mean for riders in the USA and even Canada and Mexico? Getting right into it then, who's pushing to make ABS mandatory? That would be the AMA, the American Motorcyclist Association. These guys are a non-profit group with over 200,000 members. Basically, they lobby for the best interests of motorcyclists as well as the motorcycle industry. Their mission statement is to promote the motorcycling lifestyle and protect the future of motorcycling in America. Now at a surface level, that all looks really good. These guys want to protect your best interests. I like that. But what exactly are your best interests? See, just like any other lobby group, opinions on the AMA are kind of split amongst motorcyclists, and really that all comes down to where you stand on the idea of mandatory helmet laws. The AMA doesn't actually believe that helmet laws alone will make motorcyclists safer. Obviously, that leaves motorcyclists' opinion of the AMA kind of divided between those who want the personal freedom to choose whether or not they should wear a helmet on the given ride, and those who think that helmets should absolutely be mandatory. I'm going to get right into the meat and potatoes of this video. Earlier this fall, the National Transportation Safety Board created a report. The report was called Select Risk Factors Associated with Causes of Motorcycle Crashes. The AMA grabbed this report and they basically made their own list of suggestions that should be made into law, in their opinion, in order to make motorcycling safer. And you've probably already figured out that making ABS mandatory was on those list of suggestions. So why is that exactly? Well, the data is kind of scary if you're somebody who has a bike that doesn't have ABS. See, apparently not ABS equipped bikes are twice to almost 2.5 times more likely to crash. That's kind of scary. That's a significant greater risk. What's up with that? Now, the report used variables to try and match likely scenarios, but some of their variables really don't tell a lot about what happened. For example, they used rider age, total years motorcycle licensed, total years of on-road motorcycle experience, engine displacement, whether or not the vehicle was equipped with ABS, obviously, and the average number of miles ridden per year. The thing is, other than that last one, average number of miles ridden per year, what we're not really getting is a profile of who these riders are. Basically, the data doesn't answer the question. If we took the same one rider, let's call them you. If we took you and we put you on an ABS equipped 2018 Honda VFR, or we took you and put you on a non-ABS equipped Honda VFR, same bike, same displacement, one has the ABS option, one doesn't, same rider. Would you be twice as likely to crash? We don't know. See, I'm sure that ABS is definitely going to help in some instances, but twice to 2.5 times more likely to crash? I don't know. So why are some riders divided on mandatory ABS? Well, obviously there's a question of the data. Second part is the cost. ABS equipped motorcycles typically cost about $500 more than their non-ABS equipped counterparts. That can be rough for two reasons. One, it's money that we should have the freedom to choose whether or not we want to spend. Two, it's what's called a barrier to entry. It makes getting into motorcycling harder for new riders because their first year they're having to buy a helmet, having to buy jackets, gloves. First year motorcycle insurance in most places is typically more expensive than the future years thereafter. Not only that, in some awesome states like Pennsylvania, you get free motorcycle rider training, but in many places, in fact, maybe even most places, you actually have to pay about $300, $400 for motorcycle training. So you have a heck of a lot of costs in your first year, and having motorcycles that are $500 more expensive, well, that could make or break it. That could be the difference between not riding or riding alone or being able to ride with your new best friend. Lastly, of course, is a whole argument of freedom and liberty. I mean, this is America, right? We should be able to choose what we want to have on our bikes, what we don't want to have on our bikes, how they ride, how they perform. Those are some of the reasons why riders are against mandatory ABS. Of course, the reasons for mandatory VBS are super obvious. Less trips to the hospital, maybe even less deaths. That's probably a good thing. Not to mention, if ABS does stop you from dropping your bike even just one time, the difference in price is probably covered by the damage saved to your bike. So assuming the data is valid, we can probably assume that, much like in Europe, ABS will become mandatory in at least some parts of North America in the very near future. So what's that going to mean? Well, this is all starting in America, so riders in the USA will definitely feel the change first. We'll probably see prices on motorcycles increase as the cost of tech for ABS equipped bikes goes up. And then this next part, that's just me using my crystal ball, so take it with a grain of salt. But what I see happening is manufacturers trying to take advantage of economies of scale. Rather than shipping two different kinds of the same bike, it would probably cost a lot less to manufacture and ship and carry only one kind to a given continent. So what I see eventually happening is, even if Canada and Mexico don't adopt an ABS-only policy, manufacturers would start importing more ABS bikes in bulk and shipping them to those neighboring countries in order to cut down their own costs. That, in turn, would mean a reduction in the price passed on to consumers. So while we would see an initial spike in price because of the cost of ABS, that could and should hopefully decline a few years down the road. Now I want to know what you guys think. Is mandatory ABS the right move, or should motorcyclists and our budgets decide whether or not we get ABS for our bikes? And what about you? What would you do? Would you want to spend $500 to $1,000 more on ABS for your next bike? Let me know in the comments. I'm really curious to hear what you guys think. I'm Adrian from YouMotorcycle. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you haven't already, please hit that subscribe button. And as always, ride safe, guys. Peace.